against, you know, from the start of the season against the bottom teams.
Well, it's going to be Yasser Salem to kick off for Skelmersdale, and Andy Briggs immediately chases down the pass back. Skelmersdale skewed into the middle of the pitch, and it's fallen to Briggs. Briggs plays the ball out to Comber, and Comber is in a dangerous position. He's in the box here as Connor Comber. Tries to square it, but it's cleared away in the end by the Skelmersdale defender, and a dangerous start there as Connor Comber playing in that left wing back position. Flips into the box, and it's a header at the back post. It's still in the air, and it's not gone out yet. It's not being cleared, and in the end, it falls to Ben Barnes. That was a really strange effort there. Declan Daniels was in acres of space at the near post to maybe get back to scoring form as a ball's played over the top. It's flicked on towards Comber, but that will run loosely to the Skelmersdale centre-back, but it's gone back to Berry, and Daniels is in the box. It falls to Comber, clips the ball in towards the back post, and Briggs is there, and it's into the back of the net from Andy Briggs.
Well, well, well. Really good play that. Great pressure. And Comber was just there, wasn't he? Somehow squeezed the cross in from a very tight angle. It wasn't going particularly fast, Briggs got his head to it, didn't he?
Briggs managed to head it in at an even tighter angle, managing to get it on target, and Ben Barnes probably should have done a little bit better about that, but it's 6.5 minutes on the clock, and it's Bury 1, Skelmersdale United 0, and that's exactly what Dave McNabb would have wanted from his side, who, like I said at the start of the game, were very slow out of the blocks in Burscore against Skelmersdale.
Yeah, too often we've sort of not got that early goal, and then we can sort of relax upon it a bit. We won't be doing that, though, at all today. We'll be going for more goals. I think their confidence will be knocked by the injury, and the keeper really should have done better with that.
And a chance here for Berry to break again, and Comber tries to play the ball through to Daniels, but his pass deflects off of Andy Briggs, but Comber still has it now. He's level with the edge of the box down on the near side. Comber right-footed ball into the box towards the back post, and a vital header there by... Again, nothing given from the referee, and Skelmersdale have a chance to break it. Here's Ahmed. Ahmed to Amaral. Amaral completes the switch to Knowles. Knowles puts the ball into the box and is cleared away in the end, only as far as Amaral, who strikes it over the bar, but it's taken a nick off of Skara's brick, and it's out for Skelmersdale's first corner. Puts the ball into the box, and the first header is from Ahmed, but it's a bit of a skew if one, and out for a goal kick, and ball's thrown in down the line, and it's going to break for Skarisbrook. Skarisbrook tries to switch the ball to Comber, does so successfully, and Comber has Digbu one-on-one, takes it inside, right foot strike, and it's gone underneath the keeper, and it's into the back of the net, and Connor Comber won't celebrate too much, because let's be honest, Ben Barnes should have done a bit better, but after 17 minutes, it's a goal and assist for Connor Comber. It's his 8th of the season. And it's Bury 2, Skelmersdale United 0.
Well, what do we say? He's been having so much joy, so much space on that left. This time he cut inside. Might as well have a go. There wasn't much on to his right. But yeah, again, I think the goalkeeper's to blame for that one. Probably more than the first one. Ben Barnes, he got down. It's always difficult when you get down low to your left. But he should have got more of a hand on it. And it wriggled through, thankfully. And this is a great start for Bury. Just need to keep going now.
Of course, of course. Bouncing around in A block are the Bury fans as their side are 2-0 up. Cross into Bury's half now, and it's played forward towards Salim, and Salim's got Knowles on his right. If he can find him, he goes alone instead, and Knowles isn't very happy about that, and you've got to think if he played through Skelmersdale's number 8 there, that could have been a bit of a dangerous opportunity for the visitors.
Lifted, so two goals should be enough, but we keep going for more.
Ball's flicked over towards Skarisbrick. Skarisbrick one-on-one with the keeper. It's Andy Skarisbrick. And it's 3-0 to Bury. And that's all come from the resulting goal kick from that strike wide. It's a header flicked on from Andy Briggs. And Skarisbrick one-on-one with the keeper. And he made no mistake there. It's Andy Skarisbrick second in as many games. It's his 7th goal of the season. And with just 20 minutes on the clock, this one's turned into a bit of a rout. It's Bury FC 3, Skelmersdale United 0.
Yeah, you know, we can score Route 1 goals as well as lovely lovely passages of play. That one, I thought that Skarsby might have been offside, and I thought he was going to leave it to Daniels, but he kept going. He obviously got the nod from his players. No question of offside, and a confident finish.
Yeah, and yeah, nothing that Ben Barnes could really do about that one as he slammed it into the far left corner. Anyway, left-footed ball up, and Pete's header is a poor one, and Salem's away here, and he's struck. It's a great challenge from Ollie Jepson sliding in to block the shot. Here's Pete. Strikes, and it's over the bar.
Yeah, it's worth an effort, of course. It was a direct free kick, but it was always going over.
Into the midfield, and obviously, that is where we signed it. Play. That's a great flick forward towards Daniels, and if the flag can stay down, Declan Daniels is one-on-one with the keeper. Daniels tries to turn in, and why didn't he just shoot? Gets the ball stuck under his feet, and Digby's there to clear.
But then the chance had gone, and he just got his foot in a mess there, lucky.
Lakeham Berry again with Pete. He's done well to dance past his man, play the ball forward towards Briggs. Briggs is in a dangerous position here into the box. Slides it across the box on the inside of Ben Barnes, and it was just waiting for someone to tap in, but no one was there. Skelmersdale have a 2-on-1 here break. Here's Gomez. Has Comber to beat. Takes it into the box, slips it towards Salim. It's the back post here. It's Amaral. It's a great save.
Fantastic recovery from Berry. They did get enough numbers back, but they couldn't stop the shot. Really good football from Skelm on the break. Credit to them. But Harry Wright, it is difficult when you haven't had anything to do all half.
Almost receives the ball back, but Reeves ends up with possession. Flips a lovely ball over the top towards Daniels. And Daniels, he's going to need some support. He's got Briggs and Skarsbrick running into the box. Same with Reeves. That's an unbelievable ball into the box. And in sliding in was Andy Briggs. Well, a chance here again from the goal kicks. Sandy Skarsbrick now. Skarsbrick strikes. It's a good save by Barnes.
Oh, just deflected, wasn't it? The shot.
Mounted an attack for Berry. Level with the 18-yard box on the far side. Plays back to Holland Wilkinson. Ball into the box towards Skarsbrick. And his shot's blocked by Digby. And it was a good vital block from the Skelmersdale captain. Ball over the top by Knowles. Will fall for right to Hackley just outside his box. Briggs flicks one on, and it's a chance here. Daniels is one-on-one with the keeper. Flag stays down. Declan Daniels makes it 4-0 in the fourth minute of added time. And this time he makes no mistake. It's 7-7 for December's Player of the Month in the North West Counties Premier League. And it's Bury FC 4, Skelmersdale United 0.
How many times have you seen that long ball over the top? For some reason, Skelmersdale just not having the men back. And there were three Bury players again. Any one of them were queuing up to run and score, and thankfully it is Declan Daniels. I'm pleased that he's gotten the score sheet. His play's deserved it. He missed that sitter earlier on, and now he has confidently put us into a 4-goal lead at half time.
Yeah, he got
coming off the back of a 6-0 in our last game. This is it's not bad, is it? This
it's not great. It's not too bad, is it? It's towards the box. It's headed away. It's going to be a Skelmersdale throw-in. No, it's not. The referee blows his whistle and draws an end to an absolutely excellent first half from Dave McNabb's side that started really, really early with a goal inside 7 minutes from Andy Briggs. They were 3-0 up after 20 minutes with goals from Connor Comber and Andy Skarsbrick, and then Declan Daniels in the fourth minute of additional time in the first half made it 4 goals for Bury FC.
Debut have come on. So here we go. Berry underway in the second half, kicking from left to right. It's a long ball forward from Reeves, which is miscontrolled by Daniels, but he'll have it back at the second attempt. Drake sends it down towards Daniels, who's a bit wide here. He's got Briggs in the middle. Can he find him, or is he going to go for goal himself? He's going to turn to his left. The shot's coming in. It's saved. Oh, no one could get to the rebound in time. Well done, Butterworth, though. Clips the ball in there. A real chance for Briggs, but he is offside. That's a really good positive start for Berry. Berry and Briggs can break. He's got Daniels there in space. Can he get back to him there, Digby? Crosses it in for Briggs. It's flicked clear, only as far as Holland Wilkinson. Nice 1-2 here with Declan Daniels. Holland Wilkinson with a cross. Edged out well. Good defending. And it is a corner for Berry on the break. And that was a header. Now here's Gaz Pete's corner. It's a really good delivery. And there is Briggs with a header. Just goes onto the roof of the net, and he again looked like getting his second goal. It's a great ball to Comber.
Great touch as well.
Yeah, it was. And it's worked again. Can he dig out across? No, he goes onto his left. Well played. And he's beaten his man just about. And then he's knocked over. Gets back to his feet. I don't think it was a foul. Just trying to find some support. Does really well. Comes back to Pete. Great ball to Skarsbury. Some really good stuff here. The cross comes in, but it didn't quite find Daniels. Trying to get it to Lomax Jones, but it's Skelmersdale will come away with it. They've got an opportunity here. Could be one-on-one. There's a foul right at the edge of the area. It might be in the area. What's he given here, the referee? The number four. It'll be a left-footer. Jabir flicks one into the top corner, but absolutely no problem whatsoever for Harry Wright. An easy catch. Because now, oh, it's a really good stab ball. Through to Daniels here. He's got Briggs to his left. Is he going to go on? I think he's going to try and get a shot in here. It's exactly what he did last time. He's just run out of room. No, he's won it back somehow. Daniels just looks a little tired, doesn't he? He doesn't want to shoot. In fact, he's got it back. Shot into the ground there from Reeves was not the best one, and it is blocked.
For as long as he did there.
Quite unselfish for a guy who scores so many goals, really. That's a lovely chest down to Daniels. Good football here. Berry could be in the clear here. There's a chance for Holland Wilkinson. He's through on goal, and he gets his debut goal for the Shakers. It was a really well-worked move and a lovely little finish there from Holland Wilkinson. Berry 5, Skelmersdale United 0.
Well, Adam Clark, that's probably your goal of the day, that one. He's not got his headphones on, he can't hear us say that, but yeah, I mean, unbelievable bit of link-up play between the two strikers, and Holland Jones just takes Digbu wide, has too much pace, beats him, and it's a lovely finish into the far left corner, and yeah, five-star performance after 67 minutes.
Absolutely outstanding from Berry. Probably just try and hoist this into the penalty area. Berry just going to have to deal with it aerially. It's going to go straight to Harry Wright there. Well held.
Just put a bit of pressure on the keeper there. I don't think it was all wrong with the free kick. I mean, it probably had a bit too much height on it.
But. Remaining sub. Oh, it's given away cheaply to Comber. Berry can break here. There's a chance for Briggs. Gets brilliantly ahead of his man. He's got Burns to his left. He's got Holland Wilkinson in the middle. Holland Wilkinson's missed it. But the rebound has gone in. And it's another debut goal. What a finish from Arthur Lomax-Jones. It's great to be double-barreled at Berry.
Harry Brazell like there from Arthur Lomax-Jones, just taking it one touch in the air and volleying it into the roof of the net. Nothing that Ben Barnes could have done about it, and it's six of the best for Berry. Yeah, I mean.
Goodness me, this is a terrific afternoon. If you can let us know what our biggest home win was, or the last biggest one. I saw, in fact, one of the first games I ever saw at Berry was a 6-0 against Huddersfield Town, which basically made me fall in love with the club. But since then, we had a 7-1 against Lincoln City, but you have to go back to the 90s. Brilliant block from Ollie Jepson. And again, Berry absolutely determined to keep this clean sheet here.
Ooh.
Just as I say, that's given away cheaply by Gaz Pete, of all people. And they could be in here. Chance for Gomez, the flit, and it is a goal. Berry do concede, they can't keep the clean sheet, and Harry Wright is absolutely furious. It was Gaz Pete who gave it away unnecessarily, but there was still a lot to do, and Skelmersdale have probably deserved a goal.
Fans are pretty happy.
3,000 at Gig Lane these days, which is great to see. Now it's going to be cleared by Ben Barnes, the goalkeeper for Skem. Headed by Jack.
Yeah, not something that Devon Nav's going to be very happy about.
Well, they've taken that corner quickly and short. And here is Ahmed trying to get a shot in. He gets one in. It's blocked yet again. Excellent clearance. Can Holland Wilkinson keep it in? Of course he can.
Potential 3-on-2 here. Great skill. That's unbelievable.
Great skill. Getting past Bamber Fall. Is he going to go for goal? He's got a few men in the box. Oh, he's still scored. What on earth went on there? It was a really bad clearance. It went straight back to him. No offside. They're all complaining, I think, the defence. But it is a seventh goal. Berry are winning 7-1, and it is Holland Wilkinson's second.
It can't be an offside because, Holland Wilkinson just played a 1-2 with their centre-back in the box there.
Absolutely. It cannot be an offside. And it is going to be the final sub. Andy Briggs is going to get a rapturous applause, quite rightly, from the fans now. He's going to be replaced by Benito Lowe. Not a bad guy to come on, is it, when you're 7-1 up?
No, definitely not.
So here we go. Very looking for an eighth. Can't believe I'm saying that. Is that a penalty? He's blown his whistle, but I think he is just trying to have a word with both players. I'm not sure what he's given. There's a lot of shoving pushing through. Now let's keep our heads, Berry. We do not want a sending off, especially with all those injuries at the moment. Went to ground, or did he stop it?
So I'm not
he
sure.
Blew his whistle, didn't
he? A red card. Da Costa, I think that is, number 12.
Well, let's hope there isn't one for Jepson. That's the worry now. Berry fans. That's a yellow, another yellow card. I think Jepson has got booked, and there was another yellow card for the Skelmersdale player. So their afternoon is getting even worse. They're 7-1 down here at Bury, and they're now down to 10 men. Well, it can't be a yellow card for Jepson because he's already had one, isn't he?
Yeah, so I don't think Jepson's been... I think it was a yellow for Bamba Fall.
Right.
But definitely a red card was shown to the substitute, Claudio Da Costa.
Yeah, so Da Costa has been shown the red card, and it is a penalty. So Bury, I don't believe this, they could go 8-1 up. Jacob Holland-Wilkinson, here he goes.
Absolutely no doubt whatsoever, into the right-hand corner. Keeper guessed wrong. He has got a hat-trick on his Bury debut, and Bury lead 8-1.
That is 8, by the way.
I am right, aren't I? Yeah. It is 8-1.
Yeah. I mean, absolute insane, really. I mean, I think... what this game didn't have really was a 22-man ball on a red card, and now it does definitely have it all. What an entertaining night here at gig. Well, afternoon. I'm saying night because the floor lights are on. It's getting a bit colder, but yeah, definitely a still afternoon. Nine goals, 8 of them coming by the way of Bury, and yeah. I've lost words. Really, it's an unbelievable game.
Just after 91 minutes now. Long ball. Bury here have got numbers forward. Low to Holland-Wilkinson, who has already got his hat-trick. Good ball out wide to his other goal-scoring substitute, Lomax Jones. Here's Benito Lowe. Is he going to get on the score sheet? He is! It's 9-1! And even Benito Lowe is joining in on the fun. Bury have absolutely destroyed Skelmersdale United. And I think this must be one of the club's record wins. It's Bury 9, Skelmersdale United 1.
Yeah, I mean... words can't really describe how immense Bury have been, especially in this second half, probably the second half of the second half. It's just every single time they've gone forward, it seemed like they were going to score. And yeah, Benito Lowe, it was always a formality when he came on, given what's been going on, that he was probably going to end up on the score sheet, and he's done it again.
Taken quickly. Lowe, it's looked like a handball. He's given it. It's a penalty. The referee hasn't had much sympathy here for Skep,
no.
Because there's not an awful lot he could have done about that, but he did kick it to his hand.
Wasn't in an unnatural position, you could say Skelmersdale at that point.
Here he is.
10! Bury FC are beating Skem United 10-1.
This is absolute dreamland for the Shakers, and now Sam Burns is in on the act with his first goal at gig. 8 different scorers, and there's still time left. This is crazy. 10-1.
Yeah, I mean, no mistake from the spot. Same place that Holland-Wilkinson put his hat-trick penalty in. And as I said, I feel like if Benito Lowe wanted to, he could have probably had a hat-trick with them two penalties. But to give that penalty to Holland-Wilkinson for his hat-trick and then to give that one to Sam Burns on his return from injury, it does just show how together this side are as a squad. And they have one goal, and it looks like they're going to be very ruthless in taking that goal as well.
Waste time, but you'd probably settle for 10. Okay. And that is what it will be. A record win. I think that is Bury's biggest ever win. And we are talking all the way back to 1885. What an amazing, amazing performance.